It's the S1000RR's biggest revamp since it was introduced 5 years ago. BMW say their new weapon is lighter, more powerful, and more refined than ever. To find out just how much this third-generation RR has moved BMW's superbike story on, we're pitching it head-to-head with the outgoing model. With a full performance test win and a blast on the open road, XA0, XA0, XA311, 695, price when new, XA313, 735. Second generation model with quicker steering, smoother and beefier than the original. This 3,300-mile example is for sale at http://www.bonstormeralton.co.uk. XA314, 760, yet more power. Full ride-by-wire system with WSB spec rider aids and a new exhaust. New frame has racier geometry and more flex. XA0, they may look almost identical, but these two bikes are like chalk and cheese. The red machine is BMW's latest third-generation S1000RR, and it's the biggest leap forward in the machine's short but illustrious history. Power delivery, ride quality, handling, refinement, ergonomics and steering are so far removed from the previous RR. It may as well be a different make and model. It was always hard to fathom how BMW could improve such a formidable class-leading machine. Every incarnation of the S1000RR has made the competition look silly. And indeed, the other S1000RR you see in the pictures, a 2014 model, is still an awe-inspiring machine. This U2018 old second generation RR is packed with the kind of performance only a professional racer could ever exploit on the track. And on the road, you'll only ever use a fraction of what it's capable of. It produces an eye-watering 192 bhp on our dyno and a genuine 184 69 miles per hour, banging against the rev limiter in top gear. But the key to its brilliance is how easy it is to ride. The basic power delivery, chassis balance and grip makes life aboard the 2014 S1000RR.